In this video, we will present the new patent-pending rearrange tool, which allows users to effortlessly modify design sequences, trim points, and start-exit points all at once. Let's see how it works. The first thing we need to point out is that the rearrange tool becomes available after switching from auto sequence to manual. When starting the rearrange tool, you need to click on an object to see the entire sequence of that color's layer. The connections between the objects will appear with a red line. So, this is the first one to be embroidered, and this is the second one. Then we go to this one, and finally to this one. Likewise, you can see the sequence of the blue color layer. With the new patent pending rearrange tool, all you need to do to change the order between objects of the same color is to simply drag from one object towards the object you want to be embroidered next. While dragging, a blue arrow appears showing the direction of the embroidery sequence.
Once the arrow gets inside the object you want, it turns red, indicating that you may release the mouse to apply the chains.
A connection line is then added between those objects. In this way, you can easily create your own sequence with only a few simple drag operations. The order on the sequence manager is automatically updated. As you can see here, thread trims are also automatically applied between objects. If you right-click on an item, you have the option to remove the automatically added thread trim if you want to. Once the trim is removed, a jump stitch between the parts is then added. Moreover, you may add a machine stop function. Now, let's talk about these blue and green icons that exist for every object. The green icon is the entry point of the object. It is the exact location where the first stitch of the object is to be placed. The blue icon is the exit point. This is the point where the last stitch of that object is to be placed. You may move the entry and exit points as you like. Simply hover over the respective icon and the cursor will change into a cross. While the cursor is turned into a cross, click and drag the entry or exit point to its new position. You may position it at the edge of the object or even outside the object. The stitches of the object are being automatically recalculated. Notice that when you click and drag, to connect two objects, the entry and exit points of the new connection are automatically set by the software. Sometimes we may want to have a jump stitch between two sequential objects. Instead of clicking and dragging from one point to the other and then using the sequence manager to turn off the thread trim, you may hold the Alt key down while dragging from the first object to the next. In this way, you force a jump stitch between the two objects. The entry and exit points will be set at the closest connection distance between the two objects.
When the arrow hovers over the second object and you keep the Alt key pressed down, the arrow remains blue to indicate that no thread trim is to be applied.
On the Sequence Manager, you will then see that the No Thread Trim icon is added for the object while the connection is made with a jump stitch. Likewise, if you want to force having a thread trim, you may hold the Control key down while dragging from the first object to the next. You may also change the entry or exit point of an object by using the relative option from the right-click menu while you are in the object selection mode. To do that, select an object and then right-click on it. For From the pop-up menu, expand the Chains Entry Exit Point, and then select either Chains Entry Point or Chains Exit Point option. The cursor changes into a cross, and you can set the new entry or exit point just by clicking on the position you want. If you want to reset the position of an entry or exit point to the default selected by the software, simply hover over the point and double-click when the cursor changes into a cross. You may also reset an entry or exit point of an object by using the right-click menu while you are in the object selection mode.